स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम लता नारवानी फ्रॉम माउंट लिटरेसी स्कूल झांसी. इन द लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव लर्न्ड हाउ टू बैलेंस एन इक्वेशन एंड आई हैड गिवन यू सम होमवर्क. हैव यू डन इट? इफ नॉट, हियर आर द आंसर्स ऑफ दोज इक्वेशंस. फर्स्ट इक्वेशन, N2+3H2 गिव्स 2NH3. सेकेंड, 2Al+3H2SO4 gives Al twice, SO4 thrice, plus 3H2. Third, Fe2O3+3C gives 2Fe+3CO. Fourth, 2C6H6+15O2 gives 12CO2+6H2O. And last equation, 2FeSO4 gives Fe2O3+SO2+SO3. Now, today we'll start a new topic, different types of chemical reactions. There are many types of chemical reactions, and those which you have to learn are: first, combination reaction. Second, decomposition reaction. Third, displacement reaction. Fourth, double displacement reaction. Fifth, oxidation reduction reaction. These are the main five types of reactions which we have to study. Now, coming on the first type of reactions, combination reaction. This is a very simple type of reaction. As the name indicates, combination. This means when two or more substances combine together to form a single substance, the reaction is called a combination reaction. There are various examples of this type. First example is when magnesium reacts with oxygen, it forms magnesium oxide. Now, in this reaction, magnesium and oxygen, these are two substances which are combining to form one single product, which is magnesium oxide. Now, after MgS is written in the bracket and after O2G is written, similarly this side MgOS is written in the bracket. What does these show? These symbols, they show the state of the reactants and the products. Here MgS means magnesium is taken in the solid form, O2G means oxygen in the gaseous form, they react, and then magnesium oxide, which is formed, that is in the solid form. Magnesium oxide white color powder is formed in this reaction. When magnesium ribbon is burnt in air, so it reacts to give white color powder, which is magnesium oxide. Similarly, when hydrogen and oxygen, both these are gases, they combine, they form water vapors, H2O in the gaseous form. Another reaction is H2, hydrogen gas reacts with chlorine gas, they form HCl, hydrogen chloride gas. Fe solid plus sulfur solid, they combine to form FeS, iron sulfide, which is a solid. Then nitric oxide, a gas, reacts with oxygen, again a gas, they combine to form NO2, nitrogen dioxide, which is also a gas, and it is a brown color gas. Nitrogen oxide, brown vapors or brown fumes are formed whenever it is produced. So there are various examples of these combination reactions. Some more examples are calcium oxide solid. Hindi mein isko kehte hain kali chuna. Calcium oxide, which is used in whitewashing. It is dissolved in water, liquid water. It absorbs water and forms calcium hydroxide, which is a solid. Calcium hydroxide, which has absorbed water, it is called slaked lime. This is used for whitewashing. Next example is ammonia NH3 in the gaseous form reacts with HCl hydrogen chloride gas. It forms ammonium chloride in the gaseous form. Ammonium chloride is a gas and dense white fumes are produced. As soon as these two gases, ammonia and hydrogen chloride, they react, white color dense fumes are formed which are of ammonium chloride. And on the glass rod, white color solid particles are formed because ammonium chloride is a substance which shows sublimation. From the gaseous form directly it converts, when as it becomes cooler and cooler, it converts to directly solid form and solid particles of ammonium chloride start depositing over the glass rod. So these are the various important reactions of combination reactions. Then our second topic is decomposition reaction. Now decomposition reaction, as the name indicates, when any substance decomposes to two or more simpler substances, it is called a decomposition reaction. This reaction is just the reverse of the previous reaction. In combination reaction, two things combine to form a single product, whereas in decomposition reaction, one substance decomposes or breaks into many parts, two or more simpler substances. So this is a decomposition reaction. Now, whenever decomposition reaction occurs, there are three conditions for it to take place. Decomposition of a substance can occur in three ways. What are those three ways? First, thermal decomposition. Second, electrolytic decomposition. Third, photochemical decomposition. Now, what does this mean? Thermal decomposition means when heat is supplied to a substance and it starts that decomposition reaction, it is called thermal decomposition. Second, electrolytic decomposition means when electric current is passed in a solution and it starts breaking down into its components, it is called electrolytic decomposition. Third, photochemical decomposition means when a substance starts decomposing into the simpler forms with the help of sunlight, sun's energy, then it is called photochemical decomposition. So now one by one we'll discuss these reactions. So first is thermal decomposition. Here heat is starts the reaction. So example one, first example is copper oxide. When it is heated, copper oxide is a solid which is of black color. When it is heated, it decomposes into its components. Copper metal is formed, which is a solid, and oxygen gas is formed. So two simpler substances are formed after decomposition of copper oxide. Second equation is, second reaction, potassium chlorate, KClO3, a solid substance, when it is heated, taken in a test tube and heated, potassium chloride is formed, which is a solid, and oxygen gas is liberated in this reaction again. Third reaction is mercuric oxide, when it is heated, again it is a solid, when it is heated, decomposes to form mercury, metal mercury, and oxygen gas is formed. So there are various examples of thermal decomposition reactions. Last example I am giving here, calcium carbonate, limestone, white color solid. When it is heated, it forms calcium oxide, again a white solid, and carbon dioxide is released. Carbon dioxide is a gas. For gas, either we can write G or we can put an upward arrow to show that a gas is produced. For heating, we can put a small triangle. The triangle is a symbol for heating. So these are the various examples of thermal decomposition reactions. Now, second type of decomposition reactions are electrolytic decomposition. Electrolytic decomposition means when a compound is decomposed on passing an electric current in it, then it is called an electrolytic decomposition reaction. For example, H2O, water, which is a liquid, when electric current is passed in water, it decomposes into two gases, hydrogen and oxygen. Two component gases are formed. So here, this electrolysis of water is a very important reaction, and every time questions are asked from this topic. This year also there were many questions from this. So here is an activity. I will tell you the activity, how electrolysis of water is done. Here, a container is taken, maybe a rubber container or a plastic container is taken, in which water, two holes are made on the bottom, and then two electrodes are inserted in it, two carbon electrodes are inserted, then an adhesive is added near these holes so that the water may not leak down. Then over in this container water is filled and two test tubes are inverted over these electrodes. Now these two electrodes are converted with the respective anode and cathode, and two wires are connected through these anode and cathode to the 6 volt battery. Now you know that water, pure water, does not conduct electricity. But when some few drops of acid are added to it, then it starts conducting electricity. So let us revise again this apparatus. A plastic or rubber container is taken, two carbon electrodes are fitted, then anode and cathode are joined to these, and two wires which are joined to 6 volt battery. Two inverted test tubes are covered over these electrodes, and water is taken in this, in which few drops of H2SO4 are added. Now when we, this is the switch here, when we connect this circuit with the help of this switch, the electric current starts flowing in this water, and the water starts decomposing into two component gases, hydrogen and oxygen. Now here oxygen is deposited over the anode and hydrogen is deposited over the cathode. It displaces water downwards and the gaseous bubbles, they are coming in the upward direction and collecting here. After the electrolysis takes place, we see that the volume of the gases which are produced on both the electrodes, in the first, the oxygen gas which is collected over the anode is half the volume of the hydrogen gas which is collected over the cathode. Means the hydrogen gas, the volume of the hydrogen gas which is collected over the cathode is twice of the volume which is collected over the anode. Why does it occur? This is so because when we write a complete balanced equation of decomposition of water, it is like this: 2H2O gives 2H2 plus O2. So here we can see that 2H2 and 1O2 are produced. The number of molecules of H2 and O2 are in the ratio 2:1, and this number shows the volume ratio of these gases. So the volume of hydrogen is twice or two times as compared to the volume of oxygen produced. So this question is asked, what is the ratio of the volume of the gases produced on the electrodes? So hydrogen is produced in double amount and oxygen is produced half of it. Now the question is also asked that on which electrode hydrogen is produced and on which electrode oxygen is produced. So you have to learn, oxygen is produced over the anode whereas hydrogen is produced over the cathode. Third question which is asked is, what will happen if H2SO4 is not added to water? So the answer is very simple. If H2SO4 is not added to water, it will not conduct electricity, it will not decompose, because pure water is not a conductor of electricity. So in order to make it a conductor, we have to add few drops of H2SO4 to it. Now this is important reaction, electrolytic decomposition, electrolysis of water. Second example is electrolytic decomposition of sodium chloride. When molten sodium chloride is taken, an electric current is passed in it. It decomposes into sodium metal and chlorine gas is formed. So this is all for today. Thank you.